I wonder if anyone's actually going to play Pokken. That's... I see ads for it all the time. I wonder if that's actually going to be like a thing or what the deal is for it, because people, I think, have to have multiple Wii U's just to play against each other. That's something I heard anyway. I'm playing on Xbox right now, guys. I'm trying to get my Xbox Live rank up. Currently, I think I'm like 80, rank 80. And at first I thought that Xbox was just lying to me and just putting me somewhere on there. But on another account, I saw that you can actually be ranked out of the top 100. You can be like ranked 9,000 something or whatever. Ooh, Predator. But you can be ranked really low, and it'll show you at the bottom of the top 100. It'll show you what your actual rank is. And somehow I got to like top 80 players on Xbox Live, so I'm going to try to get up there. Now that I know it's real points.
Round one, fight.
I'm gonna get warmed up. Yeah. So it looks like he may wake up, he may not. He had plenty of meter, so I'm not sure if he's gonna try it. Wow, should have been thick. Oh yeah, this guy's good. Creature Slayer. Good stuff. Oh, I thought that was gonna be done. That gotta get used to. That was a mop. It's all good. I got this. I got it. You just gotta get used to predators, traps and stuff, and hunter. Yeah. Let's see, pretty good. Oh, drops a corner combo. No punish. Yeah, it's a little laggy, but it's really not that bad. He gets opened up by the overhead easy. Yep, again. Yeah, I really didn't need to jump myself in the corner there, but I just thought he might wake up. He seems to be pretty wake up happy, but maybe he's calming down. Ugh, the overhead doesn't hit me. I waited it out, but yeah. It's alright. It's not gonna be too much damage. Oh, and he wakes up again. Great. Alright. Oh yeah, okay. Don't give me a chance. Wake up, yeah. He's scared now. It's gonna be wake up city. I might have to do the tech. Yep. So sorry, Creature Slayer. Wake up happy predators.
Reptile wins.
Guys, let me know if you can hear everything okay. Put some tunes on for myself. I don't really need to listen to the game while I play. There are some audio cues that you can pick up, but honestly, it's MKX, you know, it's 50-50s, it's guessing. It's a lot. It's definitely not a gentleman's game like Street Fighter is. So you can kind of just chill and do your YOLO antics. Everything will work out. It does take a while to find people. Maybe it's just because of the time of the day it is right now.
Faction battle. Challenge.
Ooh, that's a yellow ping. I'll do it anyway. Never back down, right? I don't have any of the DLC on my Xbox yet, but I do have it on my PS4. And out of all of them, I think that I like Alien the most. But I do play broken ass Cyrax too. Cyrax is really, he's too good. Too good. I don't really know another way to put it. Alright, so what, this is a Cassie player? Cassie, I don't really mind zoning out. Wow, this costume is so cool. I wish Reptile had a costume like this, where he was human, like somebody was just trying to do Reptile cosplay. Yeah, see, acid spit ender, keep her up. Zoning. That wasn't intentional, I just threw another slow just in case. The jump, but it's kind of lagging here. It shows you, what's cool is it shows you whenever they're, it looks like they're trying to pull out their cord, like to play on wireless or something. So it shows you whenever the connection has a spike. You're gonna die. It'll let you know because there'll be an orange, like a yield sign or something down there. It's like a sign with a wire coming out. There it is. Yeah. Of course, wake up. Now Cassie's flip doesn't have wake up, doesn't have armor anymore. So when she does wake up flip, you don't have to be as scared. It is still really fast, so she'll still be able to like reversal some of your gaps if you, you know, she didn't really need that anyway, I guess, because she backed away so much. But she's still a really good character. I just think she's going to be less used now because of that. But it's okay. I mean, she's still so great. She still does so much damage, and all of her variations are still really good. And that back one that Cassie has, that's got to be one of the best footsie tools in the game. Fellow Green Lantern player, Gross, he used to tell me, whenever the game first came out, he told me that I needed to play Cassie like him, because we were Green Lantern boys, and Green Lantern had the godlike back one. It was a low, and it reached really far. Great for whiff punishing. So he's like, man, you gotta play Cassie. I just never did. My brother picked her up, and I never thought to try to play her. Who's this guy? Oh, Leatherface, okay. I've looked into Leatherface a little bit. He's really scary whenever he gets on you. Wow, the pit is a popular stage today. But Leatherface is really scary when he gets on you, so I most likely want to end combos and spit to keep him out and start the zoning. We'll see. And he's looks like he's playing Killer. Killer, I don't know. I want to say Killer is the best. It looks like this guy's not very good. He's trying to do the stance thing from too far away. Yeah. As usual, not dealing with zoning too well. Jumping right into stuff. That was a horrible break. He didn't need to do that there at all. Yeah, getting caught by force balls is gonna be the death of him. Looks like jumping right into him. You smell of desperation. Round two, fight. He's super respectful of the zoning. Definitely doesn't need to be that respectful. I know he's got some armor. He just got his bar, so he can come in. But I'm gonna try to keep him out. Every time, yeah. Spit Ender. Keep him over there. Might as well finish him now. What a horrible break. I guess it was desperate. He didn't really have much choice. I tried to do the pit fatality. I'm not sure why it didn't work. It's forward, down, down block for Reptile. Maybe from a certain distance. Or maybe it actually needs to be done on the middle of the stage. Because it's worked before. I know I went and did it.
faction battle.
Miguel.
Riptide. Kitana.
What's up, Herm? No, I wasn't trying to teabag. I was just trying to. I was trying to do the input for the level fatality. Oh, thanks, Perm, for the follow. You weren't following me.
Shao Kahn's lackeys must die.
Katana, huh?
You, well.
You served me his lies.
Assassin Katana, which is also really popular now. I think Assassin might just be better. Because with Assassin Katana, you can still get your great zoning, but I think you do more damage than Royal Storm now because of the sharpen. You can sharpen your blades up, and you can do it really fast. Well, not a good break. I'm trying to zone with this Katana just because I want to see what's really going to be the option. Really. To beat a Katana, you just need to make sure you don't jump, but you can risk it sometimes. You really got to teach yourself to stay grounded. Okay, got a little combo here. Yeah. Okay, at least... Miguel here knows a little bit about the reptile matchup. He is trying to block overhead more often than not. I don't know why my anti-air didn't come out there. I was trying to down two. Yeah. I gotta stop doing that. I gotta stop flipping into the corner like that. I just thought that he might throw a fan, so I was gonna try to flip over it and hit him. You're on the other account, Perm? Oh, okay. Yeah, I didn't know you had multiple accounts. The online actually feels pretty good. You know, I don't mess with online too much, but this feels pretty decent. Once again, I think I played a little bit. Perm, we played when Griffin was over here. We played some, and it felt fine. I gotta get online with you guys more. I've been playing Street Fighter V, and I've been just doing a lot of other stuff. Like, I've been so busy at work that it's been hard. I'm gonna get back into it. These new DLCs were a little bit discouraging. Seeing that some of the stuff that they have, it makes the other characters look not as good anymore. If you know what I mean. What's up, Kenzo? How's it going? Especially the Triborg scene. I mean, it's gonna be big. They're great. I'm trying to do wake up again. Just fly kick over to me. Got right into a close ball. Dang it. Okay. Got the low gimmick in there. Just wanted to check him. Wow. Oh, I didn't have. I was gonna try to armor. I didn't have armor yet. Gotta pay attention to your meter, boys.
Round two, fight.
Oh, must have messed up his inputs. Okay, so he is comfortable trying to zone with me. I'm no stranger to the Liu Kang zoning, though. Definitely not scared to make a few trades. Oh, sweeps are a lot better now for most characters. And Reptile's sweep actually comes pretty fast, so it's like relatively safe and fast. Kind of a good tool to use now. Yeah, he thought I was gonna jump. I know the max range of, wow, this feels awful. I know the max range of the 4-4, and it's kind of deceptive. Like, you really don't know if it's gonna reach, but it hits right outside of his knee. Yeah, man, nice to see other people that still like watching Reptile. I think he's great, but these other characters are stacking above him pretty well. These other characters with some of their tools. Like, I'm sure you've seen Acidic Alien by now. And with Acidic Alien, he has so many of these things that I had those ideas for Noxus, like Noxus getting those. And when I would tell people about them, people would tell me, oh, that would be so cheap. That would be ridiculous. If Reptile had this, he would be so cheap. And I said, really? No, he wouldn't. And then it's so surprising to see that Alien had like most of my ideas. And, apparently it wasn't cheap. Well, maybe it is. Maybe Alien is pretty good. But still, the developers were thinking, hey, we should put something in like that. Like Reptile's meter burn puddle, that should restand. Alien does that meterless. Why can't Reptile's with meter restand? All the DLCs, in fact, all the DLCs have these restands with like Thor Raicho, the fart restand, Leatherface with his chainsaw restand, Net is like a restand for Cyrax. Pixel Pack. He's not a Kotal player? Oh, Triborg, yeah. Smoke is really good, too. Oh, this is Cyber Sub, though. Has anybody seen Sonic Fox playing Cyber Sub? It looks pretty awesome. I haven't seen anyone play Cyber Sub at his level. He's gonna let me zone him, though. Yeah, see, I was thinking about that. Cyber Sub-Zero, he kind of plays like Sub-Zero on Wake Up because he does have the slide, and he has a slide with armor.
Round two.
Leatherface 100% faster. Yeah, you know, Leatherface is in this because there's going to be another Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie. So I think it's kind of a marketing deal to promote it. But yeah, I agree. He's super fast in this game. Even with his speed, though, I feel like you're going to do best to zone him out as much as you can. And then they gave Pretty Lady the zoning tools, which is a variation of Leatherface, of course. The zoning is good, but if you want to play a zoner, there's better zoners out there. This doesn't... it doesn't work right here, I guess. I was trying to do the pit fatality again. I guess you really do have to be mid-screen. And it might be that way for all of the stage fatalities. I saw... The first time I saw the Cove fatality was when Honeybee did it. He did it to Sonic Fox, one of their sets. And it's actually pretty cool. Like a Kraken comes out and pulls the opponent down underneath the deck. I wonder what else. I don't even know what all the stages have stage fatalities. Yeah, Warner Bros. Yeah, that's... Yeah, I know what you mean. That's how... Yeah. Kenzo, really, I don't think it would be that cheap. If Reptile had a restand with the meter burn puddle, it really wouldn't be that big of a deal. That's, you know, Alien is doing this. I have like 70% combos with Alien because of all the tick damage, all the ticks and, you know, dots you put on them and the restand options to mix ups. It's ridiculous. I'm actually going to make an Acidic Alien guide, so if you guys want to check that out, it's probably going to be done. I'll have it done on Monday. I'm going to try to have Monday and Friday be my content days. Or release content on my YouTube. Okay, this Jax wants to zone. Yeah. Jumping right into it. I thought I would slide underneath him, but his feet are so big. knocking it down. But yep, yep. Let's drop city.
Round two, fight.
If I'm fighting wrestler jacks, I don't mind zoning. But you really don't want to zone with heavy weapons jacks. He'll get, whenever he gets the trade, he gets the knockdown, and that's horrible. You don't want Jax to knock you down and then be able to get over towards you free. Yeah, this guy doesn't know. He doesn't know about the reptiles only. Yeah, that's right out of range. That, I did that on purpose. Whenever you do claw knockdown, you can activate poison gas, and then you can duck, and if he wakes up with the dash punch, then it'll whiff. And if he wakes up with the overhead dash punch, it just doesn't reach. So you get to punish him there for that. The refugee camp, the cove, and the pit. Okay. Thanks. Yeah, I didn't know. Oh, you know what? Now I do know. The refugee camp is when they hit them into the air and everyone starts firing off their rifles at the person that's up there. I saw that on the stream for something that NetherRealm was streaming. That's cool. I was really hoping that there was going to be more stages, but you know, it's fine. I think they're starting to slow down on the work for MKX. They're probably already working on Injustice 2, so we're going to see less, you know, care to hotfix stuff, to patch stuff, and they're not going to pay attention near as much. A lot of people were hopeful for a Combat Pack 3. That's, I don't think that's happening. There's no way. Long live JMC. Oh, didn't want to go. Thanks, Mimi Creamy, for the follow. Thanks for letting me know on those stages. I'm gonna start doing it more often now. I think the Cove is probably my favorite. The Pit is cool too, but like the Pit is definitely my favorite stage. As far as stage fatalities go, I think the Cove has the coolest one. It was very cinematic. Ooh, stunt double. Homie? Is this homies? Shout out to DGA Homies out in Cali. He's definitely one of the best stunt double cage players. Stunt double is pretty sick. A-list is probably still the best, though, I think.
And how are we today?
Be forewarned, my anger is great.
Nothing worse than a cranky frog.
Round one, fight.
Yeah, I'm starting a lot with jump four. I want to see what people do. A lot of people jump back first thing, so I'll do jump four and try to be plus and get something to happen if they block it. Dang, it's hard to get that combo online. That's an easy 42 offline. I definitely can feel like that. They say there's like 3 frames of input delay, or you know, 3 something. It's off a little bit, and you can actually practice with it being off, and when it is, it's very hard to do combos. Yeah. A lot of people fall to the jump one overhead. This guy's wake up happy. Should have known. Yeah, it's got more hits to it. Most people don't block it. Just, this guy was, he wasn't that bad, he just wasn't familiar with the reptile matchup. It's kind of easy to see. You gonna get on MK2? Yeah. I'm gonna play all ranked for the stream, and then I'm gonna play a little bit of Street Fighter V, because Alucard, my teammate, he inspired me to get better at Street Fighter V. recently. I thought I was pretty decent, actually. And then when I played him and I played my other teammate, Sleep, I got bodied. What's up, Wise Monkey? Hey, thanks for the follow, man. Appreciate it. But yeah, so Alucard, he just absolutely destroyed me. 5-0. Sleep, he 5-0'd me as well. And Sleep has a Nash too, which might even be just as good as mine. Fat Girl Rodeo. Oh no, you declined? Fat Girl Rodeo, what a great name. You check the EX and Vince change. Yeah, I did, Wise Monkey, yeah. I don't really like it too much. You're still on Street Fighter V? Yeah, anyway. My Nash is okay, but I'm trying to get him better, and I'm about to play some online after this and see where I can go with it, because I'm not that bad of a Street Fighter player, but damn, like, Alucard mopped me up. Like, it was embarrassing. So, I gotta get better than that. I can't just go out like that. So, he inspired me to work harder at it, spend more time doing it, because I was so excited for all these DLC characters that I really haven't been playing much of Street Fighter V. And my brother Aya has, and he kind of keeps me up to date, and we watch these videos, but when I actually sit down and play Street Fighter V, I could tell my execution was pretty horrible. Fight. Sektor is kind of scary. Sektor, I feel like, has close to the best neutral of the Tribor characters, but it's like, yeah. Oh wow. Tried to get the 4-4-1 there, didn't come out. I gotta start just doing, yeah, the force ball. Ender, yeah. Neutral jump kick. Not gonna wake up, even though Fat Girl Rodeo had all the meter. I think Sektor might have the best zoning, but I wouldn't count out Cyrax zoning either. Cyrax zoning is actually pretty dangerous. Gonna be overwhelmed, and the force ball is still coming, mind you, so can't really do much. Okay, good jump. That was my fault though. I kind of laid off on the pressure. Still, that whole sequence. There we go. It is the middle of the stage. Yeah, I didn't know that. I didn't know that. You do have to be in the middle of the stage in order to make the stage fatality work. I guess for all the stages, really. Standing 4, EX invisibility, still jails into 4-4 apparently. Can you still frame trap with down 3 after 4-4-1? No, you can't, Monkey. When you do 4-4-1-2 EX invisibility, the down 3, even if you get it super tight, it's not gonna jail. They get to armor. So now, unless you do standing 4 into your invisibility and then into block string, they can armor. As soon as the opponent sees EX invisibility, there's really no risk, not much risk anyway, for them to just go ahead and throw out their armored move, because Reptile doesn't have very many moves after that he's going to be able to break the opponent's armor, especially with most people's armor in the game. It's too fast. You're going to end up getting hit even if you try 1-2. But you really need to just, I guess, use standing 4 more and it'll be helpful, because they may get thrown off by that. But standing 4 is kind of hard to get, especially at high level. Like, it's just, you know, it's a double digit high that you gotta run up and try to make happen. The range on it, I wish, was a little better, but it's not that great. Still beat Pokes up down 3, right? Yeah, I think you would still beat a Poke, but they could armor. That's really the only thing. Wow, this guy has 3,400 wins. He's probably good. 3,400. Ooh, and he plays it. Oh, Tarkatan Alien. I was excited. It's still Alien. This is gonna be hype. I thought he was gonna play Acidic Alien, which is my favorite. Tarkatan though, actually both variations of Alien you can zone out with Reptile. Even Acidic, I think I can zone out Acidic, or I can at least make him hold off on the zoning a little bit because of the force ball. Fight. Yep. So he's playing Tarkatan, which is kind of like the... This is kind of... Oh, wow, he's not having it. Yeah, you can zone. You can definitely zone Tarkatan Alien. This one is like Tanya, though. It's like a good version of Tanya. He's just set up force balls against the robots. Their neutral kills Reptile. Yeah, the aliens. I could see that. I think that's why you want to keep Alien. I like to break the game into about five spaces. There's mid, close, and close, and then there's also mid far and far. And with that, I think Alien, you want to make sure he doesn't get into the mid or the mid close. Once he's close, it's okay. Like, Reptile's pretty a lot faster than most of his stuff. But you're right, like, at those neutral spaces, mid-close, it's kind of scary. Against the robots, okay, good, we got a robot right now. So Sektor's wake up being probably most prominently, it's going to be a teleport. I think you should have enough time to do the gas and block that. You might even have enough time to do force ball and block, as long as you do the claw knockdown. I love doing the claw knockdown. It's so great. Especially mid-screen, it hits them far enough away to where most of our wake-ups won't reach. Let's run it, didn't hit. Damn it, hold on, block. Oh, below. That's right. Damn it. I was just thinking, alright, I need to block low. The overhead's a pretty decent speed there. I was just trying to press buttons. I actually didn't miss block that. There's the teleport. Just gotta wait it out. Oh, doesn't know the Reptile matchup. Unless he thought I was gonna do 4-4 slide. Maybe. Fight. Oh man, couldn't get the convert. That's an easy convert, especially off one. Try to armor. Just gonna keep Sektor out, see how his zoning does against mine. And whenever they're full screen, it seems like you can bait teleport. Yeah, you probably do have enough time. Yeah, okay. Yeah. He's pretty much done now. You probably do have enough time in order to block a teleport. You could probably do the claw knockdown and a slow force ball, and then just hold block, see what happens. Especially watch that tech roll window, and then after that window, run up and see what you can make happen, since they're going to be probably choosing to block the force ball at that point if they haven't woke up. But it's great because whenever you do a claw knockdown into a force ball, you hold block, you wait the wake up window out, and you'll see what's going to happen. Are they going to wake up and you might get a full combo punish? If they're not going to wake up, then they may just let the ball float all the way to them, and then you'll be able to run up and do pressure because they're just going to block it. But see, even if you're waiting the wake up window out and they're going to try to maybe jump or something, whenever you're running towards them thinking that they're going to block, they may jump over it, and then you can just kind of hit forward four in reverse on the other side and typically trip guard them because they're going to be trying like a jump normal. Yeah, you're right, Monkey. Like, full screen away, it's probably scary to throw them out. You're taking a risk doing it. This guy's getting in business. Looks like he knew. He knows a little bit. Oh, the overhead. Here we go. corner shenanigans. Cyber Sub-Zero is so scary in the corner. Oh, and he got time to get his little drones out. From what I know, and stream, correct me if I'm wrong. From what I know, whenever... Oh, yep, go on their sides. I gotta be careful. Oh, he's staying down. A lot of respect on the presser here. Set up, yep. Probably thought I was gonna throw him into the corner, but you know. Wake up, slide. Why do you do that? You had all this meter. So sad. So now I kind of forgot I was gonna say it. I was gonna say something about a matchup, but. Oh, yeah. With Cyber Sub-Zero, when he does put those drones out, it makes his moves different in the way that they are. Are they more plus, or they he gets more damage out of them, or something like that, right? Is that kind of the deal? As long as I have a ball out, I'm happy camper, because then I can bait them, apply pressure, and they respect too much. Yeah, very true. I'm the same way. I think Reptile in general, as long as you can... If there's a matchup... Oh, thanks Forever Trail for the follow. As long as you can get a force ball on screen, then that makes it to where Reptile can play the matchup pretty decently. Because it's almost like his little crutch to get things going. Since, especially in Noxus, the pressure is kind of stale. So Force Ball helps out a lot. Another alien, Hornitar, Tarkatan. Is Tarkatan the most popular one? Because if so, it's definitely going to get zoned out hard. Wow, yeah, I have no idea that there was a low at the end of that. Done, yeah. That was kind of a cool pressure sequence from Alien. He tried to get the jump four, which is like Catwoman's back two from Injustice. I don't know if you guys are any of you guys are Injustice fans, but Catwoman's jump back 2 reminds me of Alien's jump 4. Damn it, I didn't think he was gonna get hit by that. Yeah, you can zone out Tarkatan for sure, guys. Just try it. Like, if you guys have any friends that play Tarkatan and your character has a little bit of zoning tools, see if you can change all your combo enders to throwing them out, and then once you throw them out, just start trying to zone, because I feel like Alien, he gets out zoned by, yeah, I mean, even characters like Liu Kang and Johnny Cage, they can do pretty well zoning, even against acidic Alien.
Faction battle.
Possibly a Sub-Zero player. Still think that Sub-Zero is Reptile's worst matchup. Reptile. See if he picks Grandmaster. It really needs to be Grandmaster. No, okay, Cryo. Cryo is no big deal. Like, yeah, the slide is something to think about, but really, if you're not going to have the clone against Reptile, then it's not that big of an issue. I mean, the clone's really an issue for everyone, but since Reptile has a slow startup on the Force Ball these days, it's not like MK9. I didn't mean to do that. Okay. It's pretty respectful of the pressure. Yeah. Jump one overhead gets a lot of people. I don't know why they think that you're going to go down with a low, especially as Reptile. It must just be I think it's a common... a human thing is like you block the overhead from the jump in, then you go down to block any fast blows. Got me in the corner though. Nice slide. That was a good one. As soon as I jump. Getting close to where Noxus is gonna kill him, so I'm trying to build a little meter. Yeah, whatever. Not looking good for Jay here. He's in the corner. Oh, nice neutral jump kick. I thought you were different, Jay. Didn't know you would wake up slide like all the rest of them. Wake up hammer and see that. There's... Man, seeing pressure like that. Oh, yeah. Wake up again. That's the best wake up. I don't know why all Sub-Zeros don't just wake up with that every time. The wake up slide is so unnecessary. Especially you don't have a clone. You don't have a clone. Why do you wake up slide? You guys have like safe wake up. The Sub-Zero players, you know, they have safe wake up options. Damn near safe. And wake up slide still seems to be one of the most popular things. You guys, especially these guys that have hundreds of wins and they still do wake up slide. It's pretty stupid. They say Melina is an annoying one as well. Yeah, Melina is really good. I've always thought Melina was really good. I haven't got the chance to play Saltface, even though I wanted to, because I was chilling with all the Yomi guys like whenever they came to EGL Dallas, but he was like really tired and he didn't want to play me. He went to sleep. I was like, damn it, that's the best Melina in the world. I really wanted some matches with him. I don't know if he's still the best. He moved to Florida and he got a job doing something else, so he hasn't had as much time to play, but he still plays. And I think he gets online, so maybe I'll have to see if I can hit him up. I don't know what system he plays on, though. Right now, this is on Xbox. I'm trying to get my rank up. As stupid as it sounds, I want to have a high rank. I don't know, I'm in the top 100 on Xbox Live, so I want to see if I can get to the point where I play enough that I'm the top reptile. This guy Kenshi, oh no, he's a Boraicho.
I sensed a Saturn.
Boraicho is good too, and this is the fire, dragon's fire, I think. Is that what it is, dragon's fire?
Fight.
Oh no, dragon breath, that's right. That's Liu Kang, that's dragon's fire. Whoa, that string's got a low in it. I guess it's got a low and an overhead in it. I was out of stamina. Maybe I can zone Boraicho. Oh, nice wake up. That has armor? Gotta pay attention to that. There's the low.
Or look at the Facebook chat.
Or flip side? Yeah, 1 second. I gotta look at something after this match. I'm just gonna keep Boraicho out. I don't know enough about the matchup yet. Wow, great wake up. I'll get it after I'm done streaming. Yeah. Wow. That convert. That's so easy. I don't know why I didn't get that. Alright. Frozen. I guess this guy's quitting now. I don't know if that's what happens when you quit or what the deal is.
Riptide wins.
Thank you, Brody. What's up, Darnell? Yeah, I have a picture. Foxy plays Melina, that's right. Yeah, Foxy is, I guess he's not playing Kung Lao as much anymore, and he's decided to pick up Melina, which I really want to see his Melina. I haven't seen it yet, I just heard about it. That's going to be ridiculous.
Faction battle.
PG Frenzy.
Cool.
Scorpion got better too, right? Guys, he's like a lot better. Okay, so this guy knows a little bit about the Reptile matchup. That's the first thing you can tell, is like, alright. They block 4-4-1-2. Oh, I thought I'd have enough time to block the teleport. Not off that setup. Good to know. That's why I thought so, because normally they'll do a teleport and they won't. They'll spend their stamina. Yeah. What was that about? Right into the spear. You thought I was gonna get hit by that into the spear? No mix up even. Must have been input air. Ooh, super respectful. At least he blocked it though, so now I probably shouldn't try it. I was gonna do back one into the overhead, like back one stutter into back two. Still teleport happy though. Teleporters, you can do a double dash combo, and then you can jump up and back, and whatever all their teleports will just whiff, and you get a full combo punish.
Reptile wins.
I really want to see Foxy's Melina now. I'm going to watch that. I'm going to see if I can find... Is there any YouTube footage of him? Because that's what I want to do. I want to get on there and see... Finish her, huh? That's what a great name. Alien, huh? Oh, and here we go, acidic. PND Ketchup Twitch Masterings, alright. I wonder if Ketchup will upload it to his YouTube channel. A few King of the Hill sets. Alright, thanks man. Thanks Monkey. I just want to press buttons. Well, maybe, actually, maybe it's a girl. And then I want to press buttons, I'm not even blocking. See? The restands and how much damage I had to take. But Alien is punishable on that overhead, I do know that. He's the lag! The lag, I just spammed down three. Yeah, the Noxus killed him. But yeah, this person's really trying to pull the cord out, I guess. They're trying to stand by me, not having it. It's so laggy, I can't even explain it to you guys. Oh, it's lagging out of control. I wish there was a setting to where you could play people that... You could play them if they're wireless or not. You have the option to choose, so... Like a setting in your... It's so bad. Setting in the options menu would be so great. Should have done jump 4. Alien, whenever Alien is crouch blocking, and hopefully they'll fix it. This is awful. This is awful. Alien, whenever you're crouch blocking, for some reason, some overheads will whiff, some mids will whiff on Alien, and they really need to fix that if they haven't already. Please just give me a solid, like, just give me like a solid 5 seconds, I'll be good. Don't plug anything. Look at how jump happy. I tried to do standing one anti-air. That's not gonna happen, that's way too frame tight. Of course they'll wake up. Should've known. They'll wake up too. I mean, I guess that's kind of what you need to do whenever you... You don't know what's actually going to come out on this type of connection. Ugh. Yeah, that chip, oh my gosh. But it wasn't... Alien's not that bad. Like, I need another acidic that's not playing on wireless. I can show you, trying to zone against acidic is really not that bad. You can do it. I'll be right back, guys. I'm gonna get something to drink different than this Red Bull. I'm gonna change the online settings too. Back. How'd you like that little be right back loop I put together? That's just a work in progress. I wanted to see if it worked. Let's see, online, yeah. I got it changed to the different settings. There is no wireless option. They need that so bad. I don't want to play wireless connections. These nerds that play wireless, they gotta go. Now I understand if you don't have an option. Yeah, here we go, ping at least. I can see the ping instead of the bars, that's better. Now, I understand if you don't have an option and you have to play wireless, because I've been in that scenario, like I'm at the lake or I'm here, I can't, you know, I'm in a certain part of the house. You gotta play wireless for a little bit. I think you should be able to just turn it off and on, and you can play with your friend that has wireless and just know it's gonna be awful, and you guys can laugh about it together. But to play ranked wireless, it's almost like it shouldn't be allowed.
And how are we today?
Where do you pick? Oh, fisticuffs. This one, I think fisticuffs got buffed. Oh wow, I'm not gonna know much about it with the changes here. Gotta look into that and make myself a note. Okay, he knows the block string, he poked it, so I'm not gonna try that again. If I do, it's gonna be into the claw. And they'll get hit because they'll try to jump or they'll try to poke. Johnny Cage, like, you know, I'm a little bit cautious of him because he will do the eclipse kick in. Wow, I didn't have stamina. I needed to run underneath that jump. Dang it. Johnny Cage players will do the... Oh, what's up, Butchered? That's my boy. So, Johnny Cage will try to do that. This one wants to zone me. He's fisticuffs. He wants to zone me. Yeah. Get open by the overhead. Yeah, that's tough. Wait, I'm still waiting on it, but he chooses to zone for full screen. Which I guess isn't a bad idea. But fisticuffs, I just, you know, that's like the great pressure. I mean, they all have great pressure, actually. Yeah, he's really catching me off guard with all this zoning, but got outspaced here. knocked down. Wait, yeah. I'm waiting on that Eclipse kick, but this guy doesn't want to do it. He's been punished enough times, I guess. You gotta wait on that Eclipse kick. Duck it. Full combo punish. Like it's a whiff. You can actually punish it if you block it too, it's just a little more difficult. I guess he's gonna- oh, there it is. Okay. I was about to say, he's gonna let me zone? Those risks that I'll take. Anything. Yeah. When I'm not approached, what are you- yeah. He's done. He was gonna die from Noxus anyway, because you know I'm sliding in there. Basically, he can jail you into one of his normals, restand you, and put you in a super. It's super risky. Yeah, he does, Monkey. I didn't realize how good. That was actually a pretty decent Johnny Cage. The zoning was pretty great, actually. I'd imagine Stunt Double mixing the kicks with some of his zoning, that's gotta be great. I always see homies get in and do work, but I bet you he does some really great zoning. Some matchups, you know. Faction battle. Oh, this is Johnny Cage. I think I just fought this guy. Reptile. It's all Noxus today, boys. I'm gonna pick Nimble up some more. I really just like Noxus more, but I'm gonna play Nimble and try it out some today. But I'm playing Street Fighter before I do that. I have to play Street Fighter. It's gotta be it needs to be a daily thing for me, but it's definitely gonna be at least every other day. Still fisticuffs. Gotta watch those overheads. That's really what ate him alive that round.
Where is your mockery now?
Round two, fight.
Here we go with the start of some zoning. The overhead again. That he actually just was trying to press something. That's why I hit him there. Yeah. If we both start trading in the zoning, it's going to be fine. Talking, especially if I got the first hit, I'll keep making those trades all day. What is this? What is this? Oh, good throw. Oh, I don't think he wanted that. I guess I was still in recovery. I tried to run under and trip guard on the other side. That's one of the hardest things to do online, but it's so great offline. Throwing a force ball, watching somebody jump over it, running underneath them, and pressing forward four on the other side. It's like what I enjoy the most about MKX. That scenario has got to be the funniest thing. It gets people really good. 4-4-1-2, swipe on block, EX slide. You get a slow block, but people love to stand block, waiting for claw again. Yeah, you know, Chris, they don't even need to wait standing up because claw is not even an overhead. But I think the deal is a lot of people want to press a button after claw, and their button isn't going to be able to beat out something. Johnny Cage is fast enough to armor break you. If you do 4-4-1-2 claw, meter burn claw, he can actually break your meter burn claw. And same with like Liu Kang and Jax. Oh, DSV. They can actually break the claw, but if you do the slide, they can't. So they're not used to something like so stupid and aggressive like that. It's hella risky, but it gets people all the time. So I'm not going to stop until I see someone just blocking all of that and then blocking my meter burn low slide. But if they start expecting that, then I just get more free pressure. It's just a great conditioning tool, right? 4-4-1-2 claw. They wait for the low slide, and then that gives you enough time to do whatever you want again. DSV is good. This is where there's a DSV guy that made top 8 in ESL. Shaolin's not going to be too big of an issue. I'll play Perm. Perm Shaolin's got to be one of the best Kung Jins out there, with like really only Slayer, Big Boy. Those are the other Shaolins I know, but Perm is the guy I trained with, so I'm definitely prepared for a Shaolin Kung Jin. The zoning is good, but it's not enough to give Reptile too much of a problem. He's trying to anti-air. I don't know why from that far. Maybe he really did think he was going to anti-air me with the flip. Oh. That one wake up. Stutter string, yeah. He's... Oh, wow. I should have just blocked. I was trying to jump, but it took too long. I love Nimble too, Kenzo. I really do. I just wish that I could get more out of it, because the most common things that open people up whenever you do play Reptile would be probably back 2, forward 2, and back 3. Those are the things that I open people up with the most. And with Nimble, since you can't convert off of that, unless you want to, you know, spend a bunch of meter, it's really unfortunate. Like, I really wish that you could, that they gave Nimble a conversion out of, even if they gave Nimble a conversion out of 4-2, that would be so great. That didn't cost 2 bars to do. What's up, Mike?
Hello.
Oh, this is the new Ermac skin. Check this out, Mike. This is badass.
Oh shit. New age?
Yeah, it's like
Sub-Zero's.
Yeah, it's like Sub-Zero's version. It's probably gonna play Master of Souls. This is, I don't know, his name's Monster Inc. Monsters Inc.
That looks badass though.
Yeah.
Are his eyes green?
I think his eyes are green, yeah.
That's
what's up. Oh, saw, dude.
Dickies.
Man, I should have went with you, but I started streaming. Okay, so he's not gonna go Ermac. He's gonna go Aaron Black. This looks like a gay club Aaron Black or something. I don't know. Looks like a, I mean, not like a YMCA style. I forgot what that guy was called. It's actually kind of cool though. I actually kind of like this Aaron Black.
Reptile. Only cowards use firearms. Bad idea to insult me.
He's got a little mask on.
What is that?
Yeah, I mean the mohawk thing is kind of stupid. It's such a little mohawk, but. Yeah, trying to keep him guessing here with the pressure. He respects the pressure, so I can do 2-1 into the overhead. He's gonna get out zone. He probably wants to slide so bad, but he's gonna sit from full screen. I'm gonna make him wait. Yeah. Oh, he wants to throw something. He wants to slide so bad. We're both just building meter. It's all good, bro. Losing really in the meter war, so. Oh, I'm surprised the force ball didn't hit him. Yeah, that was a good break. It's always great to break against Reptile whenever he uses a bar first thing, because then that really makes his bar super useless. It's lagging out of control. Good lord, the wireless guys, you gotta stop. Yeah. Tried to slide, but the startup on it's kind of real.
Reptile wins.
Man, Mike, I wish I would have gone to Dickies.
You want some of this?
No, I don't want to. Go ahead. You know, I don't want to eat yours. But I do kind of want some. I might go get some of my own. If you're hungry later.
It's nice because it's just right down the street.
Yeah. If you're hungry later, we should go get some. I'm going to stream for like another, maybe like another hour. And then I'm going to take a break and get something to eat. And then I'm probably going to come back and stream some Street Fighter. Or I might play The Division with my brother because The Division is really tight. And I might get into that because it's going to be a really popular game, I think. It's kind of blowing up. And I really like shooter games, even though I play fighters most of the time. I really like shooters because they have just as much of a competitive feel to them. And a lot of the fans of Flipside Tactics, which is the sponsor, or it's our organization, it's kind of built on the Counter-Strike guys. And the Counter-Strike guys are hugely popular and just amazing players that have been doing it for a really long time. So I definitely have a lot of respect for them, and every time I play a shooter, I think about that. I think about how I have players like World Edit on my team that, you know, they're just legendary, and Markolov, I mean, those guys, those are real professionals. Hey, what's up, Original Shade? You're learning Kano, Creamy? I like Kano. I think that Kano actually can be pretty good against Reptile. You don't like Deceptive that much, don't you? Monkey, yeah, I don't like Deceptive a whole lot. I do play it, but I don't know. I have people that really know the Deceptive matchup that I play against. They'll armor every time they see invisibility, so the gimmicks are kind of limited, for sure. I gotta do stuff like do invisibility and then block, and then whenever I block, they'll armor, and if it's Jax, like, he'll do like armor dash fist and I'll block it. Wireless! And then I end up like using a bar to go invisibility, blocking, and then my invisibility's gone, so it just really pisses me off. Yep. So Quan Chi definitely felt a little bit of a nerf because of how the trance works now. This guy is pretty YOLO. Monsters, Inc. I couldn't confirm off that 4-4-1-2, I don't know, it's so laggy. But yeah, so Quan Chi, whenever he trance, pulls you in from the trance, he can't call the bat, I guess. So that limits him on his combos, he's gotta change them up. My cousin Keesler played, he goes by Keezy. You guys might have played him online some, if you play PSN. He's a really good Quan Chi, but he actually isn't playing Quan Chi as much anymore because he doesn't really like how it feels. Oh, yep. That 2-1 overhead opens people up a lot. I don't know why, like, there's not much of a mix up there. I could do 2-1 down 3 to make it pretty good, but if I was blocking 2-1-2 from up top, I typically just stay standing. What most people need to know is, like, there we go. Yeah, it is the center of the stage, that's how you make it work. But what most people need to know is whenever you're fighting Reptile, it's pretty much always beneficial to stay standing and block. Like, don't just stay hard-headed and block overhead, because that's where he's going to get most of his meterless damage, is off the overheads. I like using invis for hit confirms rather than block pressure. Yeah, Monkey, you're right. I think Deceptive, I think, is still better than Noxious, but Noxious is just like more my playstyle, and I don't know, I just like it, man. I know I might be limiting myself a little bit by playing Noxious as much as I do, but it feels like I save more meter and I make more stuff happen with the meter burn slow force ball. And now that they nerfed chip damage in this game, where chip damage really doesn't do as much like across the board, that it actually kind of made Noxus Reptile better because the chip for that is still the same. So when you're doing your chip and block strings and stuff, you gotta remember that the gas is there too, and it's really making Reptile do more chip than a lot of other characters in the game now. It's always good tool supply pressure without him is. Yeah, for sure. I tried to play MK Deception today. Still a sweet game for the last... Yeah, man, I love Deception. In Mortal Kombat Deception, I played Dairu. And I was busy doing the OTG slams, for sure. That was my dude. Yeah, the safeness of Deceptive is amazing too. Oh, a lot of people don't know that you can do back three into meter burn fast force ball though, and you'll be able to be more safe than negative 14. I think it says negative 14 on block, and it's not negative 14 on block. It's way safer than that. Faction battle. Boraicho for life, that's your boy, yeah. Oh my gosh, Boraicho was so good in Mortal Kombat Deception. Jeez. He might be that. I mean, he's trying to make a comeback in this one. In MKX, Boraicho is good. I think he's got a lot of undiscovered potential here. It's only been a couple of weeks or something, but. Camper Clutch. What a great name. Camper Clutch. And he plays Sektor. Alright.
You see a lot of Sektors on there?
Yeah, I am seeing a lot of Sektors. I see it, like, the Triborgs are in full effect, for sure.
Yeah.
Triborg.
Yeah. Triborg might be the most popular of the DLC characters. Well, Triborg is like four characters in one, so you just see a lot of the variations of Triborg. I've seen a pretty good amount of variations from Alien too, though. Oh, I didn't punish that. I know about that. That knee to the flip kick thing. That's like a full combo punch because it's a high. So you can neutral crouch it. This guy knows a little bit about Reptile, so that's why I'm hitting him up with the 4-4 slide. He's got plenty of meter though, so let's see what he does with it. Sektor can be really scary with meter. Especially with that meter burn missile. Even though it's not an overhead like Cassie's thing, it still sets him up for great stuff. Damn it, I needed to stay down. I'm just not used to seeing it a whole lot yet. This is my online combo. That's my online counterpart because I can't get the down three. So that's what I need to do. Wow, he was really efficient on his meter. That's scary. He did really well. I didn't run off block soon enough, I guess. It's kind of... This is like above 100 MS. It starts getting to feel a little janky. Oh wow, that's so good. Do the close one so that the missiles stay close. Like a combo breaker, like Trimmer. Doubt, man, I shouldn't have wasted it because I can't do that combo online. Yep, the gimmick. Force ball on the block string. He's pretty much dead. Yeah, he's gonna die from chip. Another reason I love Noxus. You get to the point where they're pretty much gonna die from chip. And if it's not close enough, it doesn't matter. You'll just do like your punishable dash or slide, and then by the time they start comboing you, they're gonna die because of Noxus. It's just really the way I like to play. That's what gravitates me towards playing Noxus anyway. You miss Cyrax from MK9? I bet a lot of people do. Cyrax from MK9 was definitely, I think, in the top five characters of MK9. I would say it's like Cabal, of course. Sonya. Kinshi might have slipped his way into the top five. MK9. Cyrax. I don't know. Jax was really good too. A lot of people didn't know how good Jax was. But Jax was really good. You could see it with CD Jr. and Tyrant, but not a whole lot of other people played Jax in MK9. I wonder if Griffin did. I can't remember. I always remember him just playing whoever. Griffin was really good in MK9. Griffin is a player in Texas, a friend of mine. Really, really good MKX player. Possibly one of the best Jax players in MKX. It still takes forever to find people in this. I don't know why. You were more of a Cybot in MK9. I liked Noob Cybot in MK9 too. He had the tackle. Remember the guy that would run out and tackle you? Me and my brother called it the Darren Sharper, because you could send Darren Sharper out and do your tackles, and you got the slide, and you got the he was MK9. Noob Cybot was such a great zoner.
Darren Sharper.
Noob Cybot and Rain are characters that I really wish would have came into Combat Pack 2, but it's okay. Whatever. I guess wait for MK11 if they make it. So we're going to the stage where we're going to lag out. This should be great. Antonio? He's going to probably see if he's a zoner Liu Kang or if he's the type of Liu Kang that actually does what you're supposed to do. Flame Fist, so hopefully he knows. Get in and try to do the pressure. Oh, yeah. I went for it. I don't know why I did back 3 meter burn claw. I guess, I shouldn't have done that. I could have just done back 3 meter burn slow force ball. I mean fast force ball, because he didn't have meter. Should have been scared of any sort of wake up. It's just old habit. He's flying in without meter. Just gonna throw him out here again, see if I can get some force balls his way. Wow. Wouldn't that be funny if it uppercutted me into my own force ball? Jeez. These 100 MS. Oh no, I didn't get the whiff punch, that was so easy! How do I miss that? That pisses me off. I was actually standing the correct distance from waiting on that, and I didn't get the whiff punch. You're out for now, alright man. Thank you, Monkey. I'll see you later. Rain from Deception is also... Rain in MK Deception? Was he in MK Deception? I can't remember. I do remember Rain from Armageddon. He was badass. Wow, this guy has 316. Definitely a good win to loss ratio. Hopefully he'll be good. Yeah, Armageddon. Yeah, that's what I thought it was. Yeah, Rain in Armageddon was so... I love that new design of him. I really liked Rain. So I thought this guy was going to be a Sektor player, but apparently Alien's popular enough, and I think Acidic might be the best. I mean, don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure... Acidic seems to have the potential to be the best variation of Alien. That's the one I like the most anyway. Let's see if I can outzone him. That's typically what I try. Yeah, they like to start with the down four. This connection's laggish. Jump four. Okay. Yep. See, I went with the safe route. I wasn't going to try the fourth wall yet. It's pretty safe just to go into the claw. Even though there is a gap there, people normally, they don't try to armor the gap. They'll just try to jump the gap if it is a force ball. Yeah. Should have went up and converted on that. I wanted to try to show you guys that I can zone against him. This is one of the laggiest connections. I know it says 160 and lower, but man. Oh man, I'm getting too wake up happy. I'm just gonna get out of here. That pressure, the 4412, the 441 into whatever you want is actually not very easy to do offline, especially against really good players. But it still works every once in a while, depending on how well you've conditioned them with 4412 claw. There it goes. See, yeah. Ooh, the sweep is so good now. Guys, the sweep is a really fast low, and I'm so happy that they buff sweeps. Makes it really feel like Mortal Kombat again, where sweeps are good, you use them. I don't know if any of you guys come from the old classic MKs, but I always played the classic MKs, and wow, the sweeps were such a big deal. You really needed them. That's just MK. You know? Sweeps and jump kicks, right? Sweeps, jump kicks, and uppercuts. That's what we do. There we go. DG 666 DG. That's like my boy Butcher 666. That's my boy Chris. We gotta play some more Reptile Mirrors soon. Butchered is really good, guys. I know he kind of floats around on Test Your Might some, sharing his ideas here and there, but he's a really good Reptile player. I kind of took him under my wing and have been training with him. He's kind of my first test in the whole Reptile training session type thing. Cause I don't know if you guys know, but Milky Situation has Reptile lessons that he provides. Off of his, I don't know if he streams them or what, but some of his viewers ask for Reptile lessons that they pay him a certain amount. And I was like, well, maybe I should do that, but I'm not sure if people would actually want to pay me. And Butcher, yeah, he can pretty much speak for me, saying that it was really good. Like, he's gotten a lot better, and maybe that's something I can actually do. A lot of low poke. Yeah, I just want to gas up and stay out. I'm okay with Cassie trying to zone me some. I couldn't move. I don't know. Deer in headlights. That was a free convert I missed. Look at this guy. This guy may not be very good. I'm giving him a lot more respect than I should. Anybody who pokes that many times in a row, it's... they're either trolling you or they just... maybe they just don't care. Maybe he's good, but he just doesn't care. There's no way that's a great strategy by any means. Yeah, I'm gonna keep Cassie out. Oh, wow. Maybe that was a misinput whenever I jumped over. Good respect, but once you get trip guard, I got all this meter. Yeah, she's done. Sorry, DG. Doesn't matter what you do, boy. Yeah, noxious boys. Reptile wins. A lot of times, at the end of the rounds with Noxious. Why, another way that it's really good is you can get to the point where they have around like 4% health left, and then just run towards them, and as long as you have like around 20% health, just run towards them and let them hit you and build you as much meter as you can to let you go into the next match. And that makes it to where Noxious Reptile is like the best at meter building, because you can do that to so many people and they'll just hit you. They don't understand. Like, they just start hitting you, and then you end up winning the match and almost gaining back another bar and a half or something stupid like that. Now, that's a good strategy, but it doesn't work against people that you're going to play for, you know, 100 games or something, because I do it to some of my friends and now they won't hit me. If I run up to them and they have 4% left, they'll just like stand there and look at me stupid, so they won't give me any meter. What is this, Bartitsu? Okay. I'm really excited to see a good Boraicho. Drake. He's got a cool combat card thing. I wonder what those were. Those logos were cool though.
The last Saturn.
No, there is another.
Round one. Fight.
Yep. People want to press buttons after blocking a force ball. A lot. This is super laggy. Alright, show, I think you want to zone out. Just the jumps all day. I can't even. Whatever. See, I'm just going to build a bunch of meter from that combo anyway. So now I can kind of compete in the next round too, in the meter war. Wow, Boraicho's got a great uppercut. What's it gonna be, a fart setup? Oh no, standing? I just wanna press buttons. No one likes this setup. Even with your lag, it's not gonna be enough. Good blocks. Oh, there's a low there? I didn't know. Damn it. I didn't even go with... I think I did press down, but not fast enough. It's really hard, that much delay. This is Lag City. This guy might be the mayor of Lag City. This is like the worst.
Mayor.
Okay. Yep. It's so funny, Mike, because they try to like pull out their the little symbol that it shows at the bottom. It's like looks like I'm pulling out a cord or something.
Down there
where it says the ping.
Yeah.
There's like this orange logo that comes up, and it's like, hey, your boy is like pulling out the cord.
Boy's unplugging his shit.
It's like flashes at you. Look at this. See that? See that little cord?
Oh, did he quit?
I don't know. It's just so laggy, like it just froze.
Oh my shit.
This is great, buddy. I think this probably is common in wireless, because it'll play for a little bit, like it'll be okay, and then it'll really mess up. Man, I'm so glad I have like the best music on SoundCloud.
Oh yeah, smoke says.
Yeah.
Forever Trail Follow, nice.
Yeah, thanks again to Honey Dab for the donation. I really appreciate that, man.
Yeah.
Still gonna take forever, huh?
Faction battle.
Easy Tashu. This person's name is Easy Tashu. Like the Kanye West song. Easy type. Easy type. Sub-Zero. Ooh, he's playing Unbreakable Sub-Zero. Okay. Unbreakable Sub-Zero got some cool stuff. My favorite thing, of course, probably like everybody, is when Unbreakable Sub-Zero slides you and has his ice aura on him, it's going to freeze you, so you're going to be stuck for another combo. I don't know if Sub-Zero has like cool setups, but maybe even stuck for like a setup.
You would risk your race's extinction.
The threat of it makes me dangerous.
You evoke pity, not fear.
Still with Sub-Zero though, I'm not too scared as long as they aren't playing Grandmaster. It's really not gonna be that bad. Cause you can freely zone against, not freely, but you can feel a little bit more comfortable zoning against a Sub-Zero that isn't Grandmaster. Good boss, man. God, I should have committed the back 3-4. It would have clipped him out, I think. But yeah, with Grandmaster Sub-Zero, you really just can't zone him because your zone tool is just going to be caught by the clone, and then his zone tool is going to make a better trade. You got to be really careful with it. See, that's the setup for a lot of Sub-Zero players. You'll do Claw Ender, and then you gas up and low block because they might try to slide. You can't do Force Ball. When they see a Force Ball, they might even be reacting to it and sliding. Press the overhead. The overhead's punishable by 4-4. Yeah. We're gonna have some slide wars, I guess.
Reptile wins.
Easy touch. That's a great name. So hungry.
Listen to this?
No, I think I'm gonna go get something. Unless we have stuff here to make.
I have some meat left over. Some.
Okay.
We got green beans.
I still have my sandwich from Mod Market.
Faction, oh, yeah. Challenge.
Utaru. Oh, Hotaru. That's creative.
Reptile.
Katana, huh?
Katana.
See if he plays, yeah, a set. Mournful, okay. I typically see Assassin Katana, but this guy's gonna try out Mournful. I think I might have played this guy earlier, so now he's trying a different variation against me. Probably what it is. I don't think Mournful's gonna do any better. You're probably fine as a Katana player. You're fine using Royal Storm or Assassin against Reptile. It's gonna be a little weird because of how the zoning is gonna work. He can get way up there and throw that boomerang down at an angle, but. It's kind of hard to deal with, but not really. It has less distances that it works. Ooh. Maybe I can't punish that one. You know, a lot of Katana players will use Fan as the end of some of their block strings, and you can just reversal dash, Reptilian dash, punish it. But against this variation, maybe you can't. I'll have to look into that. That's something I definitely want to double check.
Round two, fight.
You don't see very many Mournful Katanas. Typically, every time it's a Katana, they use... That was reversal, but it looks like he was moving, so maybe that's a little safer than the Fan is. I tried to do knee slide again, it's not coming out. 200 MS. So you know we're just chilling on the inputs, wondering what they are. Wow. NJP hit me from that. Yeah, I'm just trying to get underneath. It looks like... Oh, it's going to kill me. It looks like that this Katana player is just going to really see how he can thrive off of the Mournful zoning. But it's not going to work out. Like, I'm going to get in there and then end up beating him up. He keeps doing that. Yeah. Because you can do Reptilian Dash and then run underneath. That's going to be my plan. Wow, very respectful of the force block. I was expecting a jump. Watch that Reptilian Dash in. Do it again. Yeah. See if I can get this in. Oh my gosh. The down three was just non-existent after that. It's all good. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Like that sort of zoning, especially the top of that, that huge height that he was putting on it, that allows for a Reptile to get in easily. He must have, he thought he had something going there, and then it just didn't work out. So how was the division, Mike?
It's time. I'm like level 15 or 16. So
what kind of route, the trees, like which route did you choose?
I went the medical and tech route, which is medical is like where you can heal yourself and stuff and heal others, and the tech route is like you can throw turrets out and like you have these little bombs that will like seek out enemies.
Yeah.
I'm just like,
I got Hotaru again, so I guess he's going to try Tanya this time. Kobu isn't as popular. You won't see Kobu anymore online, I guess, just because people are scared of how it was changed. But, you know, the other variations are good. They're okay. Let's see. I haven't really played against this variation, so I don't know much about this matchup other than it has range and you can do like a pogo stick thing. Looks like I can still hit her on the air with the acid spit though. Oh wow, yeah, I need to be kind of... This is going to be a funky match. Like, wow, that was just supposed to be 2-1, I got 4-2. But yeah, I'm gonna... Wow, that teleport really set him up. Oh, he broke my armor. That was good. Though. Yeah, I can't get him out of the air. He's just all... He's just up there doing whatever he wants. Just pogo stick all over. Jumping around on me. Come on, he's gonna kill me. It's alright, I got this. He can't. He's not gonna do that to me. Don't worry. Yeah, this online combo. I didn't get it. Try the anti-wake up tech. Wow, okay, so I thought that fourth ball was gonna hit it. Especially whenever you extend your hurt boxes out like that, like with her jump one. It should have hit, but it didn't really work. Tanya might have kind of funky hurt boxes. We're just gonna jump. We're just gonna be jumping on the trampoline, I guess. Smell of desperation. Final round, fight. Yeah, ooh, he's just trying to press buttons. I don't even like it. Here's a wake up tip, yeah. That's like for all the nerds that love waking up. Do forward one, dash, jump four. And they can't even, if they were trying to get like a down two, they can't get the down two out. This is so annoying when he's jumping up like that. And I have a hitch. My nose. Yeah, I just want to jump around with him. This is Trampoline Party Boys Jump City. Look at this. Oh no, you had the conversion. We're just jumping all day. Wow. That was ugly.
Reptile wins.
I hope I don't have to play Hotaru again. That was awful. I mean, I can't blame him. He's trying stuff. He's trying. If I could just talk to him, I could tell him like what to do against me. He's trying to figure out a way around Reptile. Didn't really work with the katana zoning. So at least what he was trying. That jumping around with Tanya was interesting, but it really wasn't enough to. That's not, especially offline, that's not going to be enough to just to annoy Reptile enough. Okay, this guy almost has 300 wins. Picture of Boraicho, so maybe he plays Boraicho. Oh no, he plays one of the robots. Smoke. Okay. Smoke, I think, is really good. I saw Beyond Toxin playing Smoke on Honeybee's channel. He was really good with them. I like Smoke a lot. If I played one of the Triborgs, it'd probably be Smoke or Cyrax. But I really don't want to play him. Fight. I know one of the things that I need to remember against the robots is they don't really have they don't really have like a ranged overhead, except for Smoke does because of his teleport. His teleport is an overhead. This is Lag City again. This guy's on the council. Pledge talk. He pledged himself to the Lag City Council. Oh, I couldn't punish that. He's trying to do more stuff even after that. That thing is really punishable. It's like Scorpion Spear punishable. Damn it. Didn't get I was trying to run up in 4-4. Okay, what's the vortex? Damn, okay, so he's just going with the combo and it's Lag City. Ping is out of control. You're unplugging your stuff. Jeez. Need the lag police. This is ridiculous. Okay. Got a lot of things going right. I pressed that. I don't even know. I can input stuff right now, but I'm not sure if it's gonna come out. Maybe I should block for teleport. All right. Jeez, this is horrible. Yep, it's uppercut. It's overhead. I get the punish yet? I press 4-4-1-2, whatever. I don't even know how that came out. That was so laggy. This is horrible, guys. This shouldn't be. Let's see the fatality and lag. Yeah, that's what I did. This shouldn't be. That shouldn't be legal for ranked matches. Or it should just be a setting. Like it wouldn't be that hard because your Xbox or your PS4 tells the network if you're playing on wired or wireless, because it lets you know like through the system settings, and that system settings is telling obviously the Xbox server. So it wouldn't be that hard to allow a setting where there was only wired or only wireless. In Street Fighter, you have the option to play with a certain amount of, it says like a rating, like there's a rating for how good their other connections are. So I don't know what it is really. I'm just going to say it's like a 4-star rating, 5-star rating. So you have the option to choose whether or not you want to play people that have like a 3-star rating and below if you want to. But you could say, no, only find me like 4 and 5-star ratings. That's all I want to play. So Capcom's doing a lot of stuff right. Speaking of Capcom, I don't know if any of you guys play Monster Hunter, but Monster Hunter X, or MHX, Monster Hunter Cross, I guess is what they're calling it in Japan, is actually coming out to the US, and it's going to be called Monster Hunter Generations. And I don't know about you guys, but I absolutely love Monster Hunter. It is one of my favorite games to play whenever you just want to chill. You don't want to have these fighting games, you know, be stressing you out. Because these fighting games they're very taxing on the mind. You got to think so hard. And in Monster Hunter, it's kind of like a big boss fight. You just team up with your friends, you fight a bunch of different bosses, and, you know, kind of grind them out, get different equipment, and do it again. Like, fight bigger monsters. Really fun. I think I'm going to try to stream it, actually. I'm going to see if I can get a capture card from Japan that works on the 3DS and try to stream it. Fight. Dr. Pepper 3-9. Oh no, he might actually be a good Raiden. Raiden's still the corner carry god. One hit to the Superman and then you're in the corner. I'm trying to see if he punishes his ass. I wish I could confirm 4412 Reptilian Dash. It's so hard for me to do online. I probably just need to get used to the timing of it. This guy's pretty respectful of the pressure. Oh wow, he caught my back dash with the overhead. Great. Yeah. He's like dead from Chip, or from Noxus anyway. Even if he would have got that NJP on me, he was like dead. So, it's not good. So I love Noxus, boys. That's what you do. Jazz hands. And you're in the corner, so what's it gonna be? Yeah, that setup for Raiden is just the same as other people with really fast wake-ups. So you claw, and then you activate the poison gas. Hold block for just a second, like watch the window, and see if they do, like for Raiden, he would do like a Superman when he gets a full combo punish. For some reason, the gas baits it out, and they wanna try it. Yeah, this guy's not gonna be able to deal with the pressure. But... yeah, but that's kind of like how I want to play Reptile now. I want to do combos that always end in the same type of setup, and depending on what the character is, I want to choose my option that's gonna allow me to block the wake up window, and then after blocking the wake up window. And maybe getting a force ball out and still being able to block the wake up window, because there are certain characters that you can do that on. I want to see what happens. And if they choose not to wake up and they choose, oh, you know, they're just going to block, then you kind of get pressure again, because if they're just going to sit there and block, especially after they tech rolled, it's going to tech roll and block, then you kind of get to watch that force ball float towards them. And then run up and see if you can get some pressure started, because they're still holding block. They're going to block the force ball, and then you're already, you know, at free motion. You could be moving at that point to press a button. So let them block the force ball and then start some pressure, or even try a jump in. Like if you don't want to run all the way to them, let the force ball float towards them, and as they're blocking it, do a jump in. They're not going to try to anti-air you, because if they do, they would get hit by the force ball. So their only other option a lot of times is like. Well, the only other thing they do most of the time is like a jump. So if they try to jump over the force ball as you're running towards them, you just trip guard them on the other side, or at least start pressure on the other side as they cross over. Here's a Goro player though. This guy might be an MK4 fan. He's got the Noob Saibot card, and he plays Goro. MK4 players, y'all know what's up on that. I don't have to explain that. Wow, the armor is ridiculous on Goro. Not ridiculous, but you know what I mean. It's got two hits of armor. I really gotta be cautious of that. I do have some setups in order to break his armor. It looks like this guy is actually pretty good. Oh yeah, low after that overhead. Wow, he did the... I guess he held back in order to still clip me. A lot of times when you see Goro go up into the air for the stomp, just do Reptilian Dash. There was the run under, see what I mean? He chose to jump, so run underneath and get the the 44 on the other side. This guy, his ping is like in the 60 area, so you can actually do stuff like that. Once it gets up into the hundreds, it's like kind of hard to make that happen. But it did just happen to him again there. Damn, I couldn't get the fourth one. Yeah, that's what I get for spitting on board. I'm trying to watch to see if he's going to jump again, because I just want to rip Tealion dash. Oh, I think he's baiting me out. He's doing a neutral jump to kind of fake out the stomp. Yeah, I think that's what he's doing. This guy's kind of smart. Armored the fourth ball gap. I shouldn't be trying this late in the match. I don't need to see if it works right now. I'm just being stupid. Oh wow, I can't even caught him hit. Goro's got a weird hitbox. Caught me. Yeah, on Goro, whenever you do run to the other side on the combo conversion, do 2-1, 4-4-1-2. You actually have to make sure you run up after you 2-1. Some characters you don't have to. Oh man, good punish. I just thought he would jump, that's why I rubbed Tealion dash again. Because he's jumping a lot. Wow, I thought that would be a little punish. Let's see how he deals with the fourth ball pressure, jumping right into it. And spin him away from me. I definitely want to try to zone Goro, because you don't want him coming in and making you guess on all the punch rock shenanigans. Okay, yeah, set up for that. Should have been enough to kill, but it's all good. The Goro matchup for Reptile shouldn't ever be that bad. Not that Goro can't win, but if you can keep Goro out, it's probably in Reptile's favor slightly. I'd say maybe 6-4 Reptile for most of Reptile's variations. Even though Goro did get better, it still may be 6-4 because it's just, I don't know how it works, like how it lays out. Whenever you play most of the match from full screen, it makes it hard for Goro.
Faction battle.
DSV Prince. Oh no! I want to play another DSV guy. Dang. Maybe I'll get to. I don't know why I declined. My connection is fine. I play on. I have Verizon Fios, and it runs at 150 up and 150 down. So it's really good. There's really no reason to decline. Oh, here we go, Kujo. Kujo's a really good Liu Kang player. Kujo is a really good Liu Kang player. I hope he plays against Liu Kang. He's just a really good player in general. Whoever he chooses to play, it's gonna be good. Come on, Kujo. Maybe he has an Ermac too. I saw his Ermac in there. Ooh, Boracho. Guys, this might be what I want. A Boraicho at high level, possibly from Kujo. Let's see what we got here. Kujo's real tight. I think he plays with Milky a lot. So he definitely knows the Reptile matchup. But Boraicho is a whole nother animal. Trying this, okay. Yeah, Boraicho still, most variations of Boraicho, I think you can zone out. Because he really doesn't have a projectile. Stay out here. Yeah, most variations of Boraicho, I guess with the exception of Dragon's Breath, there's really no projectile. Oh, and with the With Dragon's Breath, the only projectile that you can do, I think, requires meter to get that fireball to go across the screen. Yeah, wow, I'm so lucky that I got both those to hit at the same time for a combo. But that's why I messed it up on the Spit Ender. Shouldn't be getting hit by that creature. Wow. Now he's got me in the corner, about to see something sick, maybe. Oh, he was... I think he stuttered the stream. That's the one where the low comes afterwards. And he does like that Sonya looking uppercut. Oh, the overhead. Uh-oh. Big da- Oh, he dropped it. Yeah, you're not gonna cross me. I'll wake up. Jumping in the corner. Meter burn slide into the corner. Catch a lot of people even as an anti-air. And you, your arms, a lot of characters' arms won't reach down, but their feet are hanging, so you'll get hit. It's really exciting to see a lot of the DLC, though. People are wanting to try the DLC out, especially in ranked. I wouldn't, like, my alien's okay, but I wouldn't be playing my alien in ranked. Some people probably don't care, though. They're just like, whatever, who gives shit about ranked? No, nobody cares. It's just ranked. It's just... whatever, it's just MKX, you know?
Action battle.
The guessing man's game.
Challenge
accepted. All right, Lucas. 1,400 wins. Maybe he'll be... he should be good. 1,400 wins. I haven't even played 1,400 games. Johnny Cage?
Johnny Cage.
A-list? Wow, okay. This is exciting. Johnny Cage, A-list is still really good. I think if you are kind of the kind of person that likes to play pressure characters, then... A-list is probably where I would point you first, because Liu Kang's pressure has been consistently getting nerfed. Like, I don't know. I don't know if I could warrant reason behind it, because it's good, but there was still stuff you could do about Liu Kang. Just people were so annoyed, and I think that caused him to get nerfed. So now Johnny Cage has like all the same stuff, and he's able to keep it and fly under the radar and be better than Liu Kang as far as that. Pressure is. Oh, good tag. Unless we're just speeding. Yeah, he's probably just pressing things. Oh, man, I got hit by the overhead. Really, yeah, you should block. You should block overhead against Johnny Cage more often than not. But. They will poke you, like they'll poke you really to the point where you're so annoyed. Yeah, they'll poke you so much where you want to go down to block low, and then the overhead gets you. Yeah, this connection is kind of laggy. We're at like 200 ms. Let's see what we can make. Setups, wow, good choice. I should have like done a down three. I'm gonna keep that in mind against Johnny Cage. I think you can down three whenever you're running that, and maybe low profile, but I don't know. Down four, I guess you could. And then it would end up breaking his arm. This is gonna be fine though. This guy can't deal with the zoning. Just gotta keep him out. He's pretty respectful. He's respectful whenever you get full screen, but up close, like, he's ready to try to... he wants to try to mess up my setups with armor. That's what he's gonna do. Flawless, Lucas. Sorry, bud. There's setups whenever you just do a meter burn slow force ball and then slide. And even though it's unsafe, if you're fighting somebody who's gonna try to wake up, a lot of times it's going to break their wake up. It breaks like super fast wake ups, like all the wake ups in the game pretty much, like the exception of Kung Lao's only reptiles, I guess, and Sub-Zero because they're low. But like pretty much every other character in the game that doesn't have two hits of armor on wake up, you can do meter burn slow force ball setups into slide, and the slide will hit, so that's one hit of the armor, and then the slow force ball is following behind like very closely. So then that's the next hit, and it pops him into the air, and then you get the full combo. So it's really... oh, Dr. Pepper for the win again. This is the Raiden player. Who's actually... this Raiden player is not bad.
Riptide.
the refugee camp. The stage, I guess, this is one of the ones that has the level fatalities. It's so cool that they added that. I love that. I kind of wish it was for more stages, but you can't. Can't get everything here, of course. Some passage would be great for that time. Yeah, super respect for the setup. Of course, he did that meter, that's why I tried it, but this guy knows me now. I'm starting to realize how to play this up. Is that... that overhead is functional, right? Maybe. You can count on Raidens to do their Superman. Good little punish there. Oh, we caught with the overhead. Yeah, this guy's good. Okay, got a little reset there with the low. He's gonna have to deal with this pressure sequence though. Yeah, we're gonna break all of it. Can't be doing that like that. Come on, are you for real? Wow, he wanted to just get hit by the force ball, I guess. It was right in front of his face. He just pressed buttons.
Reptile wins.
What's up, future? My top five characters in strength for Combat Pack 2. Okay. I think Cyrex is the best. Next up, I would probably say... maybe Cyber Sub-Zero. Sektor's really good too, so Sektor right underneath that. Then Acidic Alien. And then I guess I would put the Bartitsu version of Boraicho underneath that for slot 5. But I don't know enough about Boraicho in general. Brant was telling, Pig of the Hut was telling me that, or was saying that there's a lot of dirt on Boraicho that people just don't know about. So maybe Boraicho is, it could be the best. But, oh yeah, I forgot about Leatherface, but I haven't had any problems with Leatherface yet. He can kind of get zoned out, and I don't know if he's going to be that much of a problem, because even if you go to your zoning variation of Leatherface, the Pretty Lady one, the zoning doesn't really hurt that bad, and other characters that can zone him, like I play Kenshi, for example, I had no problem with Leatherface as Kenshi. Where I played Kenshi. Fight. Kirk the Perk. Molina's pretty scary, especially now. Ooh, nice. I gotta stop. Wow, I can't believe that hit me. He's wondering why too. Yeah, Molina's one of those characters where you can get a slow force ball after the claw knockdown, and then you can block for any possible wake-ups here. I don't know what he wanted there. Get her out. Go over there. I should have not even blocked that. There we go. I just need to be getting hit right now because it's going to build me meter. I guess I don't need any more at this point, but he's dead. Whenever they get that low on health, they're going to die from the poison gas in most scenarios, unless they actually get smart and try to zone, but it's going to be really hard to outzone Reptile or to even zone him in general. Okay. Again, I tried to just like fuzzy guard. I don't even need to. I don't know why I did that. I don't know what I could have whiffed punish with. I thought about it for too long. That 16-bit says, if you think, you're too slow. If you have to think, too slow. Sorry. I'm gonna use all this meter this round to turn it around. I'm not sure how to approach this guy yet. Good roll. Like, really risky, but hey. Wow, he did that really low. normally my answer for, again, that's 3 for 3, wow. Again, my answer for dive kick is definitely just block the dive kick and then do armored claw, because if they do try to throw a psi, hold on a second. Not overhead, the second part's not overhead, so you stay down. Okay, so the answer for Melina's teleport kick, what it's not even an overhead, is block it, and then you can do meter burn claw, because if they do try to throw a psi at that point, they'll just get hit out of it. I know you can block and then uppercut, but it seems weird because they can like wait. The block stun's kind of weird on it, so they can like wait and then do a psi at these like different times. But for me, I just that's why I just like to do the armored claw. Seems to be the best answer for it. Full combo into a setup again. Hands of God. Okay, 3,000 wins. So you know this guy's good. I don't even think I have like 300 wins. Oh, when he plays Ermac? Master of Souls Ermac? This is going to be good. Master of Souls Ermac, even though Mystic is really popular right now, I think Master of Souls Ermac is still really good. Hard to tell which one's the best. Some people may say that it's still Master of Souls, but Mystic is really good too, especially with its buffs. And people didn't even know about how much life it gives back to you, but it's always done that. Okay, so he's already playing kind of gimmicky here. Caught me with the low. Wow. Yeah, this is. Oh. Wow, I couldn't even get the punish though. It like spaced me away from the 4-4. That's not right. Oh. Now I see. 200 MS, that's why. He was probably able to step back slightly or something. He was pressing something. Oh, the overhead. Don't want that to open you up. That's my little online combo. That's nowhere near optimal. It just works if I can press the buttons fast enough. It always comes out.
Desperation.
200 MS. Living the life. Living the Ermac high risk life and not getting punished. Damn it, why did one. Reptile is so dumb sometimes. He doesn't want to turn around and just do 1-4-1 in the corner. It's just NRS corners. Oh, caught me with soul. I was trying to run up and block that. I always would, but I guess that's not a thing today. Oh, I could have sworn he was going to get hit by the overhead. I took a risk because he could have woke up there, but he didn't. Oh, I don't know if I would have broke there. Well, turned good for him, I guess. If this Ermac player is going to let me zone him, then that's not going to be good for him. He's going to have to start teleporting more, which is what I want, so I want to condition him to do that. He's not exactly a chance. Bad break. Just desperate though, I guess he's about to die. This is not going to do anything to give me a meter. Yep. He didn't want to respect me, he just straight up was trying to throw a soul ball. I have got to block low on that, please! Block low. Oh, that just caught me out of the air. I think Noxus might kill him from here, we're close to it. Yeah, he dropped the combo. He actually would've killed me, but he's dead. Yeah. He would've killed me if he didn't drop the combo there. That was close. He is a really good player, but that was super laggy. Thank you. In your top five, not including combat fights and cares. I communicate through a translator, so sorry if something's not clear. Oh, no problem, future. My top five, not including the combat. Look how laggy that is. My top five, not including the combat pack two characters, would probably be... Wow, that's kind of a tough question since all of the changes that just happened. But I would... I can't put them in any particular order. That's going to be my problem. Like, that's... I'll list five, but I don't necessarily think that one is better than the other. But I would say Jax and Sonya fill up two of the slots. I feel that Melina fills up a slot. So then I got two more. I would say... Wow, that's kind of tough. Not including Combat Pack 2. I have to look at the character list. Let me see right here. Not Trimmer anymore. Trimmer was really good, but he's not. He's definitely not in my top five. Johnny Cage. So that's four. And I don't know, really, for the flip on that stuff. One second, I'll think about it. So this is Acidic Alien, which I think I can zone out. I want to show you. Should be possible. He's the character that you don't want to come into that mid-range or like mid-close. You definitely don't want him there. He's trying to abuse that jump four on me. Which is going to be actually really good in the Reptile matchup. But not if you're jumping in the fourth mode with it. There's a gap there, but he didn't have armor, so he couldn't really do anything. Yeah, that's punishable. I'll just put Katana in there. Make Katana, probably. Assassin Katana. So that'd be my top five, I guess. I really don't know enough. Like, I need to play more really high-level players again to see where the top five really is. And I'll find out, like, at final round, and I'll try to see if I can get a lot of matches. See how much they respect the back one. I was going to do back one overhead, but I decided just to do back one into more pressure. Oh, that's punishable. I didn't actually get the good punish. Like, I think he was pressing buttons, but... Online City. I mean, Lag City. I'm just gonna do like a couple more matches, Mike, then we can get on the division.
Hell yeah.
Online is definitely a lot of work here. Trying to get opponents, apparently. Server's working real hard.
Faction battle.
Mystic Arcana. Reptile. Wonder who he plays.
Sub-Zero.
Oh, Grandmaster. Yep. This is gonna be tough for Reptile. The reason why Grandmaster is so tough is definitely because of the clone, but a smart Sub-Zero can really make this hard for Reptile. This can be pretty tough. See if he knows how to play it right. For me, I'm gonna risk a lot of meter burn slides to see if I can get into the clone.
Round one, fight.
Because you know that's gonna be a common theme here is the clone, and I shouldn't be making these trades. Damn it. I gotta really ground myself and get used to this. I wouldn't have broke there. Slide, yep. Sub-Zero's, no need to do that. I'm trying to wait on the slide. Do it. He wants to slide. He wants to slide. Wow. Oh. I didn't have meter, damn it. That was going to be the little pressure gimmick with gas. I was so close to having it. I just kind of didn't see in like that peripheral vision. Oh, yep. Slide and reach from there. You can actually throw that clone downward now. Oh, I shouldn't try that. You can throw it downward to cover pretty much all the angles you need it to. I didn't get frozen, so I lucked out on that. This guy is pressing buttons hard. What the hell? I'm telling you guys, this matchup is so broken. Like, you can't flip into the, you can't slide into the clone. He wasn't even blocking. And the slide still didn't hit him. I'm broken. This is... Yeah, see, you could actually throw that down. That's why I was still blocking. I don't know if he did that, though. Maybe he did. Wow. Yeah, that's my fault. No respect on me. On that. I was ducking, and whenever he throws it with meter, it's actually a mid, so it caught me. Try to slide. You're in the corner, not where you want to be. Take that sweep there is punishable going into them. See, a lot of chip was happening there, more so than most characters in the game, especially because I had the gas on. Gotta love Noxious. Slide. He's up there. I just wanted to slide so bad. Oh, that was meter burn slide, and I just got a 4-4. Yep, I was gonna convert off that and really make it hurt. I do like that he got a little bit more patient there towards the end, but he still, you know, he's trying to play the basic Sub-Zero where you just put the ice clones up, you throw ice balls behind it. Sometimes you throw a slide out to try to catch the opponent off guard. And it's really annoying. Possibly the most annoying thing for Reptile to have to deal with. But that's why I play Kenshi too. Because if you're going to fight Sub-Zero enough and they just do that same thing over and over again, then you can just play Kenshi and really blow him up, because the spirit charge stuff that Kenshi has and his Telefury or whatever it's called just goes right through the clone. It makes the matchup 10 times better. Balanced Kenshi might 6-4 Grandmaster Sub-Zero, honestly. I think I talked with Pig of the Hut about it, and he's like, it was kind of a longer time ago, it was like around Evo, but I talked with him about it, and he said, yeah, like, he doesn't mind at all fighting Grandmaster Sub-Zero with Kenshi. It's cake, I guess. Wow, hungry boys. Trying to drink a little bit of water with the Red Bull so that my insides don't melt out. Good practice. I think one of my friends, like, for every soda that he drank, he always made sure to also drink a bottle of water with it. That way, it, you know, it really got him to drink more water. Wow, 1800 wins. Really got him to drink more water, but also it's just a lot helpful for your body, because you can drink Cokes all day and you'll be super dehydrated. Okay, so Kung Lao. Buzzsaw Kung Lao, which I don't know. Did Buzzsaw Kung Lao get buffed pretty well? Or I really didn't look into it much. Because with Kung Lao's jump 2 being nerfed, that actually helped out Reptile a lot. At more distances, it's safer for you to throw a force ball. You won't get jump 2'd as easily. This guy's gonna... Buzzsaw typically will be the Kung Lao that I feel like they try to zone with. Wow, I don't know how I didn't get that punch. Oh wait, almost 200 MS on that. Yeah, that's right. 4-4 just came out of 4-4-1-2 just came out as like 1-2. Didn't even register the 4-4. Yeah. Let's see what I mean. From certain distances like that, you can throw the force ball and they're gonna try to jump in with their jump 2. They're used to it being just so godlike that it's all good, but actually it actually helps out toss some. This guy's super respectful. Surprised they didn't get a spin in between that pressure sequence. Normally when someone's respectful like that, it means that they're pretty good. Not sure why he did that. Maybe he thought I was gonna dash him. I got a misinput. Damn it. He's doing pretty good at working one of his conditioning tools on me. He's zoning and then teleporting to try to get me to zone back with him and then make him get something out of his teleport. Yeah, that was pretty lagged up for sure. I like the little logo at the end there. It was like beep beep. Lag boys.
Reptile wins.
For him spam. See what we got next. Is anybody gonna actually play Pokken? You know, I don't get it. What is going on with Tekken? Oh, the Great Liu Kang. I think I've heard of this guy. But seriously, like what? So Tekken 7, when are we getting it? Or is it coming to the US anytime soon? And why are we being blinded with Pokken Tournament right now? Oh, Mike, look, he plays the Ermac, the costume.
Oh, shit.
This guy's probably pretty good.
Yeah, we'll see what looks like.
Type, but what, like with Pokken, it's like another Tekken thing, I guess. And I just don't know what they think of us. Like, why are they, the American market just gets kind of dumped on? Oh, his eyes are green. Yeah, that looks so cool. That's a Ermac's like safe armor move to do. So he kinda wants to use that. Ooh, caught me with the soul ball. That was hella risky because I was thinking about jumping in. Good combo here. Oh my gosh, I'm trying to run up and block that. And one of these days I'm gonna block the low from that jump thing. Oh! That didn't actually mix him up, he just was pressing buttons. Oh, why didn't I get the conversion? I think he might have got mixed up there, or maybe he was pressing the button, I'm not sure. Those little stutter strings are really what Reptile can thrive off of at first. Especially online, do the 4-4-1. Let's see, if he's not going to be a person that wakes up all the time, then you get that as a ender 2. 2-1, 4-4-1, slow force ball and then run up the pressure again. Kind of risky, but that's neutral. Yeah, I caught him luckily before that slow ball came out. Only to end up with this. Figured he'd be blocking my wake up. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Why did I even do that? I could have just done back three down fourth one. Like, it's just habit. It's habit for me to always press the down back two because I don't think about it. Down back two meter burn. It actually is good. Like if you do like a hard knockdown and you're gonna try to cover your options on their wake up, you can do hard knockdown, back three meter burn claw, and if they wake up, it's just gonna like. You're gonna take one hit of armor, and then the next hit that you're dealing, which the part of the claw will actually be what hits them out of their wake up. Because back three is the hit that breaks the armor, and then meter burn claw is the one that takes them into the air. And since you have armor on it, like, it's all good. Just don't try it against characters with multiple hits of armor.
Faction battle.
Super Tauntaun. This might be my last match. Let's see who he plays. Oh, what's up, Gandalero? How's it going, man? It's been a long time. Oh, this is the version of Alien that... Is Rafael, what's up, buddy? Simply the best. Nice. Yeah, this guy this guy's playing the like setup version of Alien. You guys are coming in right when I'm leaving. I'm about to, after I play this match, I think I'm gonna get off and I'm gonna try to play some the Division with my little brother. Yeah, that's so good that he can go underneath the force balls with that crawl thing. Even though that's punishable, if you space that right and just crawl underneath, that's really good. What? That hit me. I was on the other side. Tauntaun likes playing with some lag for sure. Oh, I couldn't even point that. Yeah, he's like wondering what's going on. It's so laggy here. Respect the claw. There's no gap between 4-4-1-2 claw, guys. Stop pressing button. Super Tauntaun. Hasn't tried any of the egg setups yet. There goes one. Dang. Yep. I decided to go for it. I figured it might wake up. I might catch him. Super Tauntaun. Well, it's been good, guys. Hope you enjoyed the stream. Kind of a shorter one, just because I got my little brother here. He really wants to play the Division, so we're gonna play that. I'm going to play some Street Fighter V and stream that as well. But, you know, it's all good. I'll be on MKX soon to do this again. Thanks for tuning in.